In this video, we'll be looking at Chapter 8, Section F on cumulative data. Take a look at the frequency table below. Notice that the data values, which in this case are weights, are given in groups or class intervals. And so we don't actually know the specific data values. We know that there is one data value between 65 and 70. We know that there are two data values between 70 and 75. And we know that there are eight data values between 75 and 80, and so on and so forth. Also remember that the left-hand number here could be included in this class interval, while the right-hand number would not be included in this class interval. It would instead be included in the next interval. When we have data values like this, it's sometimes helpful to know how many values lie above a particular value and how many values lie below that particular value. We can find this information out by constructing a cumulative frequency distribution table and a cumulative frequency graph. Now, we already have been given the frequency graph, or we know how to construct it from previous videos. And all we need is an additional column here to find the cumulative frequency and to turn this into a cumulative frequency distribution table. So here's our new column, and at the top of this column we're going to have cumulative frequency. Now we're already familiar with how to find the values in this column as we saw it in the last video. Essentially we're going to add each successive column. So the first column is always the same frequency number that you see in the first row. So if this is a 1, this will be a 1. If this is a 5, this will be a 5. It's always the same. We then add this 1 to the next frequency, which is 2. And in this case, I'll have that will give me 3. And then I add that to the 8, which gets me 11. And then I add that to the 16, which gets me 27. And so on and so forth. So what types of information can I get here? Well, first, I now know that there are 80 data values in this data set, and that's really important to know. Also, if I take this cumulative frequency right here, which is 48, I know that there are 48 values, or in this case, people, who have a weight less than 90 kilograms, right? And I get that from the class interval that's associated with that cumulative frequency. I know that all of these data values are less than 90, because remember, 90 actually belongs in this class interval. So there are 48 people who weigh less than 90 kilograms. Now let's take a look at the cumulative frequency graph. Let's quickly take a look again at the cumulative frequency table, which we created in the last slide. And now we're going to graph this data. And the two columns that we're going to use to graph this data are the data values, which in this case is weight, and the cumulative frequency. We're not going to use the frequency for this graph. So here's our graphing space, and on the x-axis, or the horizontal axis, we're going to put our data values, which in this case is weight. And remember to always label your axes. And on the vertical axis, we're going to put cumulative frequency. And the values we're going to use on the x-axis come from the weight column in the cumulative frequency table. And I'm going to start with the left-hand value on the first class interval, which in this case is 65. And 65 is going to go here. And then I'll have 70, and I'm going to skip a few numbers here, 80, 90, and so on and so forth. On the vertical axis, I need to be able to go from 0 all the way up to 80. So I need to spread out my axis accordingly, and I can label it like so. Now this is very important. I'm always going to start at zero cumulative frequency, and that is going to correspond to the left-hand value in the first class interval, which again is 65. I can then use the right-hand value in that interval to represent the first cumulative frequency, which in this case is 1. So I'm going to place a dot at 1. And then the next dot will be at 75, which corresponds to a cumulative frequency of 3. And then the next dot will be at 80 with a cumulative frequency of 11. And here are the rest of your data points. Notice that the top interval, it has a cumulative frequency of 80, and it corresponds to the right-hand side of the last interval, which is 115. I can now connect up these dots using straight lines. So here's our cumulative frequency graph, and there are a few key things to point out. You should almost always have this nice S-shaped curve, as the frequency of the data increases more steadily and then decreases quickly right in the middle, and then we get smaller changes towards the top and the bottom. Also, that this first point is going to be zero, and it's going to relate to the minimum data value possible, and this last point is going to be your highest cumulative frequency, which is the total number of data values that you have, and it will relate to the highest possible data value. Actually, just less than 115, because 115 isn't actually a data value that you can reach. Now remember, for this data set, we actually don't know the true data points. We only know the number of data values that occurred within each of these ranges. So we can't calculate a median in the normal sense, but we can use the cumulative frequency graph to help us estimate a median. So remember that there are 80 data points, and if I add 1 and divide by 2, that gets me 40.5, which again tells me that the median is the average of the 40th and the 41st data points. Now because the data is ordered and we have the cumulative frequency, I can go up to the 40 and 40.5, I can go up to 40.5 on the y-axis, and I can draw a line over from that value, from that cumulative frequency, and it should be right on top of that other line until I hit the curve. Then I can drop down a line to the horizontal axis, and we see that I'm at about 88, or what should be 88 kilograms. And that is my estimated median. Another piece of information that might be useful is finding the number of men who weigh less than 83 kilograms. And again, since we don't have the actual data points, we can't read that from the cumulative frequency table. So I use the graph, and in this case I'm going to go to 83, which is about here, draw a line up, and then I can draw a line over. And that line was a little low, it should actually be closer to over here. And because my graph isn't entirely accurate, and you would be drawing on much better graph paper here, I calculated a value of 19, so there are 19 men who weigh less than 83 kilograms, and your book calls it 20. And we can see that there's a little bit of error here depending on how well you draw the cumulative frequency graph. So the more accurate you can be in your drawing, so using graph paper, using rulers, the better. Now, if I wanted to find the number of men who weighed more than 92 kilograms, again, I'd go to the x-axis and draw a line up from 92 until I hit the curve, and then I would draw a line over. And I see that that would hit at about 56. So all there, remember there are only 80 data values. So 80 minus 56, and the 56 represents how many men weigh less than 92, would, if I subtract those two numbers, I get 24. And that represents the number of men sort of between these two cumulative frequencies, or who weigh more than 92 kilograms. Remember that these are all estimates, but it is a valid statistical method, and it gives us some data when we otherwise don't have the actual data values to work with.